Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you a complete school administration management system using PHP and MySQL. As you can see here, I have one zip file, that's school administration management system. And by the way, this is a complete project. So I'll provide all the source code for those who are going to contact me through email. And also I'm going to provide my email in my video link description. So when you download this zip file, what you want to do is just right click, then extract all. But for me, I've already done that. Here it is. So if I open this folder, you can see another folder. This is the project we're talking about. So I'm going to go to my local disk C and search for my XAMPP, and this is my XAMPP folder. So inside XAMPP, I have this htdocs. This way I'm going to drag my project. And here it is, you can see. Let's just go through. You can see now I have my complete project inside here. School Administration Management System. Okay. So if you're wondering what is XAMPP, XAMPP is actually like a server for your project to run your project. Actually, it's a server to run your project. It's usually used for run PHP and MySQL projects. Okay, so you can install XAMPP onto your machine from Google. Just search XAMPP, then you can actually download and run the software. So let's get back before we do something. Let me just search XAMPP. So this is my control panel. I'm going to start my XAMPP. You can see you will see this dial this dialog box that is XAMPP, my control panel. This panel, you can see now I'm using Apache and MySQL. So what you want to do is we only need Apache and MySQL. For that, I'm going to say start and start. You can see we have it's make sure here at the in your terminal there's no error at all. Next, we are going to do is go to admin. If we click admin, it's going to take us to our database inside the PHP MyAdmin. Now here we need to create a database before we run the project. For that, I'm going to say create new, or you can just actually click database, and then here for your database name, you need to click school admin. Then you need to click create. After creating, we are going to import our database. Don't worry, if we go back to our folder and we click here, you can see we have this folder DB where we install our database, and it's .sql. So come back to your Google Chrome. Here I'm going to say import. Then you choose file. After file, you go to local disk C and click XAMPP, then htdocs. And here is our project, school administration management system. If we click, we're going to search a folder called DB, which means database. And here we have our schooladmin.sql. That's our main database. And now we open. Next, what you want to do is we click go. And here it's going to process all our data before we actually run the project. It's going to take a while, so just be patient. You can see it's loading. Please be patient. The file is being uploaded. Now successfully created our database. You can see there's no error at all. You can see this our database school admin. We have different tables, classes, sections, students, attendance, teachers and users. So next what I'm going to do is come here. Now we're actually going to run the projects by doing localhost slash school administration management system. Now, this is the name of our folder. school administration. That's how you run. Make sure you copy the exact name of the folder. Come back to Google Chrome. Now let's run. Sorry. It should run actually. Now you can see our project is successfully running, and this is our front-end page. You can see this my logo. You can add your own logo, okay? But for me, I added text here. That's my logo. Next is I have my navigation bar. You can see courses, our teachers, and this is the admin login. Now for this one, I'm going to show you later. This is our backend of this project. Now let me show you the front end of this project. You can see we have our title, school admission open for 2021 to 2022. Then we have this dummy text. Then we have this apply now. Next we have is our about the school. Next we have our courses, the courses we offer. Next is our teachers, the world-best programmers and experts in the IT industry. You can see there's no hover effect, so I just created this using PHP and MySQL. And next is our achievements. Achievements, you can see we have graduates, total graduates. And next we have this section of what people say about the school. And finally we have is our footer. Can see we have useful links and social presence, and lastly newsletter subscription. Subscribe now. And lastly we have this copyright. Okay, next if I click this is go useful links, it's going to take me to my home page. And if I click about us, it's going to take to our about us courses. And finally, our teachers. Now we are done with front end. So let me show you the back end. Now I'm going to log in as an admin because this is a school administration management system. Now you can see we have this login page, and we can actually have we have this one link, anchor tag, where you can just, if you click, it's going to take us our previous page. Go back to home page. Now let's go back. Yeah, I'm going to log in admin. And if you're wondering where I'm getting this password, is because if you go to your database here, PHP my admin, and you click school management system user, you can see is the email for our admin, and the password is in hash code. Don't worry, I'm going to provide you the both the email and the password. Okay, so I'm going to enter my password. Login. Now you can see we have this amazing dashboard. This is my school administration management system dashboard. Okay, now you can see I have school. Next is I have this alert message, welcome Codmo, Mr. Codmo, and I can actually click cancel. You can see this is my dashboard for the school dashboard. This is the school dashboard actually. We have dashboard, manage students, manage classes, manage sections, manage teachers, manage courses, manage attendance and attendance report. Also, you can view from here, manage students, manage teachers, all this, okay? Also, we can log in, but let's not do that right now, okay? So first, let's look manage students. What you can do this section, okay? If we say manage students, here is where we manage the students, and also we can enroll a student. So let's say we have, you can see we have the ID of the students, registration number, the roll number, name, plus the photo of the students, the class is going to take, and section. Okay, now let's enroll a student, and you can see at this amazing dialog box is going to appear, and it's like our registration form, okay? It's like an admission form, okay? Admission form. We can add a new student. So let me just type a random number. And the roll number is going to be 12. Select, yeah, you can select 2021. And the date is, let's say 07/. Okay. Select classes, and you can see we have all these courses that the school offers. Let me choose cyber security, or you can choose full stack development. Next, I'm going to select my section. Name of the students. I'm going to click my name. Then we can actually choose image. Yeah, okay. You're going, if you want to choose a photo of the student, when admitting the student, you choose file. And let's just pick a random image, okay? I have this bunch of images. So let me just pick one. Next, I'm going to say the gender, it's male, date of birth, email. So this is just an example, okay? Father. Now, if we save, let's admit this student, okay? The address is Susuwa Road. This is just a random address, okay? And you can see the mobile number, address, father. You have to. Okay, let me just submit. If we save, you can see now we have admitted a new student, okay? You can also update the student by clicking here, and you're going to update any new information about the student, okay? Also, we can delete it, and you can see you're going to receive this alert message. And are you sure you want to delete this student? Before we do that, let me show you and go to my database, select students. You can see the database is here. It's okay. We have inserted the data. You can see the new student that we have admitted right now. This is the information about the new student. Let's go back. Also, if I delete it, and we'll say okay, and now let me refresh this database. You're not going to see the data there, okay? See, it's gone. You have deleted. You have successfully deleted. Next is manage classes. Here I can. We have the list of classes that we offer, plus the courses, plus the class teacher. Also, we can add new class. We want, let's say, introduction to Excel. And I'm going to select a new section. Let me say like D, or let me just select a section first, B, and let me select assign class teacher. I'm going to say let me pick a random number, and then I click this button, add class. Now you can see we have successfully added this class. Okay, you can also delete it or update it, and you can see the same alert message you're going to get is, are you sure you want to delete this class? If we delete, it's gone. Next is manage section. Here we can manage our section, and we can also add new section if you want. Let's say I'm going to add this one, save it. Same again if you want to update it. And maybe let me choose different letter section. Still, you see, you can also delete this section. Next is manage teachers. Okay, you manage teachers. Here we have the list of teachers. You can also do the same, update or delete, and you can also add this new teacher by using this add new teacher. Okay, and you're going to recruit a new teacher, save it. You can see it's added, and all this data that we are deleting and updating and inserting, it's all updated here. Okay, when we're deleting here and updating and inserting new data, also from the other side of our database, also it's doing the same process. Okay, next you can see is manage courses. Here we manage courses. You can see we have graphic design, we have ID of the course subject, I mean, and we can also add new subject if we want, whether it's and also you can choose subject type. Okay, it's optional. You can say either it's theory or practical. For IT, mostly it's practical, And so sometimes it's theory, it depends, okay? And you can also add the code and also add. Also you can update or delete. Let me just try this. Let me change this update. If I say update and I click theory, you can see now it's going to change. The subject type is going to be theory. Now let me go back and here to our database and let's click subjects. Now you can see our graphic design is theory. As I said, if you change something from here, also the other side in our database is going to do the same process. So you can see if you come back here again, I'm going to update it to practical and save it. And let's go back to our page. Now you can see we have changed graphic design into practical, okay? The type subject, okay? Subject type. If I refresh, it's going to be practical. See? It's going to change. It's going to do the same thing, okay? Now let's come back here. Next we have is manage attendance. You can also manage attendance of this school administration management system. Now if we click full stack, this class, I'm going to check their attendance. I click search. You can see we have one person, and here we can choose the status. We have this attendance. We can choose present, late, or absent, or half day. Okay. If I click present and click save, you can see we get this message that says attendance saved successfully. Now let's go back to our database, phpMyAdmin, and click attendance. You can see now you're seeing numbers, okay? Don't worry, these numbers are the one who inserted this in form of numbers, because if you look here, if you come back here and if you see this have like it goes 1, 2, 3, 4. I've used integer. I didn't use characters, okay? I used IDs. So I'm using ID, you can see, to check whether the person is present or absent or late or half day. Okay. Next is my attendance report. Here I have my attendance report. Click full stack, and if I click this and click search, you can see no data available. But let's try 20. Let's try maybe let's go to manage students attendance, and let me add. Let me search students. Okay. If you click here, search here, I'm going to say save attendance. Attendance already saved. Let me change to this late. Click OK. Now for my attendance report, let me go back. And here I'm going to student attendance section. Okay, I'm going to report a new attendance. Okay, let me just select from section A. So guys, that's all for today's video. I'm going to provide you all the source code. I'm going to provide all the source for those who actually going to contact me. Okay? So till next time, bye.